A resupply mission wraps up at the space station, a new name for an Earth-observing satellite, and preparing for an unprecedented peek at the sun. A few of the stories to tell you about this week at NASA. More than 2 months after delivering several tons of supplies and scientific experiments to the International Space Station, Northrop Grumman's Cygnus cargo spacecraft left the station on January 31st. The company is targeting February 9th for the launch of its next Cygnus filled with supplies and science for the station from our Wallops Flight Facility in Virginia. The Sentinel-6 Michael Freilich is the new name of a satellite launching this fall to uncover new knowledge about our oceans. NASA and several partners renamed the satellite in honor of Earth scientist Michael Freilich, who retired last year after 14 years as the head of NASA's Earth Science Division. We are collaborating with the European Space Agency for the upcoming Solar Orbiter mission to capture the first ever pictures of the Sun's north and south poles. Data from the mission will help us better plan for and mitigate the potentially harmful effects of solar activity on technology and astronauts in space. The new season of the NASA Explorers video series called Microgravity looks at the International Space Station's unique research capabilities and follows a team of scientists through the process of conducting an experiment aboard the station. Episodes are available on the NASA Explorers Facebook and NASA's YouTube accounts. On January 30th, senior officials and others from NASA headquarters attended the annual Day of Remembrance observance at Arlington National Cemetery in Virginia. The annual NASA event is one of several around the country in tribute to the fallen astronauts of Apollo 1, Space Shuttles Challenger, and Columbia, and other members of the NASA family who lost their lives in support of the agency's mission of exploration and discovery. That's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on the web at nasa.gov/twan.